Ladies and gentlemen, ever since the government announced its flagship and very pet project, the Central Vista, it has been marred in controversy. The opposition compared it to criminal wastage, to Himalayan blunder, to what not. In fact, the Delhi High Court today settled the debate. While the debate has once earlier been settled by the Supreme Court, the Pandora's box was opened yet again, because this time it was the second wave of COVID-19 that allowed yet another debate to be opened up in the Delhi High Court, and a hearing that the Delhi High Court has settled once and for all. Tearing apart the arguments made on this case, the High Court has ruled that the project is of national importance and that the construction will not be stopped. That's the unambiguous order that's come from the Delhi High Court. It went a step further and imposed a 1 lakh penalty on the petitioner for putting up what the court called a motivated plea. This has come as a hammer blow to the anti-Modi bloc, which has taken refuge under construction of Central Vista to target the Prime Minister and the Modi Sarkar. Armed with the judgment, Urban Development Minister Mr. Hardeep Puri, in an exclusive interview to me earlier today, said it's a relief, not a victory in these times, and that the Congress's false narrative, which he says is part of the anti-Modi toolkit, which has been demolished by the High Court today. Listen in.
It is the virus which is the enemy. This is a once-in-a-century crisis. And we should all work together. The Congress Party, on the other hand, many of us even, they want to call a particular strain by a particular name. They are celebrating. Anything seems to be going wrong, Congress Party wants to celebrate. You know, they are electorally, they've been wiped out in Kerala. They've been wiped out in West Bengal. I wish them the best of luck. You know, it's a pity from our point of view, because every government, especially one with a strong majority, leads a healthy opposition. But these guys are fragmenting. They can't make up their mind. They produce false narratives and then they get caught. I want to be careful about my language. They've scored a self-goal. So I'll put it milder. On Central Vista, there is no perception problem. These guys have created a problem. I was hesitant to speak before the judgment because, you know, if I as a minister say something, you'd say you are trying to influence the court. I did not give a single interview till the Delhi High Court judgment came out. When we had the parliament issue, Central Vista issue, disposed of by the Supreme Court on 21st January 2021. I don't remember the exact date, in January 2021. After that, we thought things were normal. But they turned around, and when they can't get something, they will create a false narrative on vaccine. They will create a false narrative on Central Vista. And the toolkit that they prevail, the toolkit on Central Vista, they have not even said it's false. They've owned up to it. One of the points in that toolkit which they produced on Central Vista is file a case in the Delhi High Court. They've done it. We've now got the result. So I don't regard this as victory. In all humility, Madam Navika, let me submit to you, I think it is a reassurance that we are on the right path. And if we have to tweak it, if there is any future vulnerability on account of the virus, we will do it. But we are not going to stop our mandated economic activity just because some guys out there are producing a false narrative.
Well, despite the setback, the Congress remained unfazed and still loves to call it an attempt to satisfy the Prime Minister's ego amid the pandemic, branding the project as Modi Mehel.
Is making new aims is more important, or making new Modi Mahal is more important? Is this the way? Is this the way democracies functions across the world? Ki nagrik mar rahe hain aur aap apne liye Modi Mahal bana rahe hain un sab ke beech mein. So neither economically one can justify, nor morally one can justify, nor ethically one can justify.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's just look at this entire controversy with our eyes on the logic, which is what the Delhi High Court did today. And let's just put out the observations of the Delhi High Court. The Delhi High Court has said Delhi Disaster Management Authority order nowhere prohibits construction work. Legality of the project has already been upheld previously by the Supreme Court. Time is of the essence in the contract. Work has to be completed. As workers are staying on site, there's no question of suspending construction in light of COVID-19. The Delhi High Court also says it's an essential project of national importance. Public is vitally interested in this project. The petition is not a genuine public interest litigation petition, but a motivated one. And that brings me to the legitimate question tonight on the News Hour. And the question is just simply this. Does the opposition owe Prime Minister Modi an apology tonight? That's the question and the debate. Vista vindication for Modi. That's the hashtag and the debate coming up.
You're watching the News Hour at 9. Debate number 1 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
And joining me tonight, Dr. Sambit Patra, national spokesperson of the BJP, Shehzad Poonawala, lawyer, political analyst. Also joining me tonight is Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari, national spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party. But my first question goes to Mr. Abbas Hafeez, who is somebody who supports the Congress Party and is a political analyst. Abbas Hafeez, badi koshish ki. The Congress really opposed the Central Vista. I just want to ask you, was it totally a motivated opposition because there is construction of the ITPO that's also going on at the same time? If COVID was your concern, maybe you should have opposed the ITPO. Did that escape the attention of Priyanka Gandhi Vadra, of Rahul Gandhi, other Congress leaders who have objected to the Central Vista? Because Sirf Central Vista, Modi Mehel, these kind of words came from the Congress Party. What is this obsession with targeting Narendra Modi when the Supreme Court and the Delhi High Court have upheld the legality of the entire work and now the legality of doing it in the COVID period? Are you defenseless now?
Whoever is accountable, Navika ji, will be targeted or will be asked questions, will be asked to that person only. But I want to know this thing. You are very much well aware, and everybody is well aware, that the Congress Party was not the petitioner in the Delhi High Court. They haven't gone to file the petition that please stop this work or something like this. It is being, you know, telecasted as if Congress Party has lost the case. And this is not the final court also. If we go back in time, like not many days, but if we go back a month, many high courts have criticized Mr. Modi's government, local BJP governments. So will that define BJP government as incapable or their work as not sufficient to save the people from COVID? So I don't think that there should be 100% agreement on any high court's order. And BJP in the past has done the same thing. BJP was not, BJP disagreed with many high court orders. I can tell you here some orders also. But where the Congress Party was only of this opinion and is only of this opinion that right now the time is not appropriate. Right now there should be other things in the health sector.
Now allow me to come in. Abbas Hafeez Saab, allow me to come in. You said that we are calling a judgment against Congress Party. I have never called it a judgment against Congress Party. But yes, you were the biggest opposer to this Central Vista project. You have, and Rahul Gandhi has put out tweets, because he doesn't write edit page articles. So he's put up several tweets. He has done press conferences whenever he's felt like. And he has opposed this concept of a Central Vista. I just want to ask you one question, Abbas Hafeez. Does the opposition owe an apology because aapne kaha tha ki ye jo hai, ye ek monumental mistake hai and And you had said this is a Modi Mahal when the Modi house is not even part of the first part of the construction that is taking place, at least till the December of 22. Will you apologize to Prime Minister Modi?
Not at all. Not at all. If a government is too adamant on its megalomaniac activities, then they don't deserve any apology. The timing is wrong. When people are dying because there is no oxygen. We haven't expected something like this in our whole life. We have seen people dying from our family. We have seen people dying everywhere. आज जो ग्रामीण क्षेत्र में लोग देख रहे होंगे वो कह रहे होंगे कि हमारे घर को बचाना ज्यादा महत्वपूर्ण है. ये चीजें बाद में हो जाएंगी. हमें वैक्सीनेट करना बहुत महत्वपूर्ण है. Right now we don't have funds sufficient. The states are lacking funds for sufficient amount of COVID vaccines. Amit Patra's party is, a defaulter in GST returns, GST, the loss, GST loss compensation. So there are many things which have to be paid
Patra,
by the center
Dr.
government.
Dr. Patra, so in 1100 crore mein se hi GST ka refund defaulter jo aap hai, wo bhi dena chahiye. In 1100 crore se aapko desh se garibi bhi hata deni chahiye. Aapko inhi 1100 crore mein se aapko is desh ki har problem solve kar deni chahiye. Kyunki 1100 crore jo aap kharch rahe hain Sambit Patra ji, usi ki वजह से देश की आज ये दुर्गति है. यही कहना चाहते हैं कांग्रेस पार्टी के सपोर्टर अब्बास हफीज. रिस्पॉन्ड टू हिम डॉक्टर पात्रा. रिस्पॉन्ड टू हिम.
अगर घर में दूसरी चीजों,
अरे भैया आपका रिजॉइंडर पात्रा साहब दे दें. आपका रिजॉइंडर सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने भी दे दिया था, दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट ने भी दे दिया था. अब पात्रा साहब को भी देने दीजिए. आपने बहुत लंबा पॉइंट आपने बोला. पात्रा साहब रिजॉइंडर देंगे.
Navika, ironically, what has happened is, from the Congress's toolkit, the spanner and the jack has fallen on their own feet and they have fractured their feet. But despite all this injury, look at the Congress's vanity. I mean, the two essential words which I really want to put it over here. Word number one is vanity. This is what Mr. Rahul Gandhi tweeted for the project. For the Vista project, Rahul Gandhi said that this was a vanity project. What does the court say today? The court says this is not a vanity project. This is a vital project, quote unquote, vital project. You can see the tweet of Mr. Rahul Gandhi where he says that as far as the Central Vista is concerned, this is a non-essential project. While the court categorically says today, this is an essential project. So whatever Rahul Gandhi had contested, in fact, he has fallen flat on the face. And Mr. Rahul Gandhi today has got a slap from the court of this country. Can I please speak, sir, without your interruption and background music? Sir, don't look so abusive to me. And please, sir, I don't talk. Navika, I'll keep quiet. The Congress people have really gone abusive. They don't allow others to speak. I'm extreme. They're all abusive. They don't allow others to speak.
And you don't agree with the High Court.
Abbas Hafeez Sahab. 1 minute. Allow me to come in. Abbas Hafeez Sahab. There is one minute that I want to take of yours, and I want to just tell you that High Courts and Supreme Court have made several observations on several other issues and performances of the government. I completely agree with you. On the vaccination issue, they have pulled up the government and said, wake up and smell the coffee. I am not contesting those facts and those observations. Having said that, let us stick to the debate, which is on Central Vista. And on Central Vista, the High Court and the Supreme Court before it have said neither is the timing wrong nor is the legality suspect. So Abbas Hafeez, aap thoda sa bolne to de. Kam se kam jis baat par BJP ki sarkar ko aaj High Court se support mila, unhe bolne to de.
Thank you.
Boliye Patra sir.
Thank you Navika. Navika, what did the High Court say today? The High Court said that this PI, in fact, was a motivated PI. And this is what we say. This toolkit and this Central Vista's toolkit by the Congress Party, in fact, was a motivated toolkit to see to it that we don't move ahead with the construction activity. And secondly, the High Court categorically said that these are not genuine PILs. This is not a genuine PIL. And the objection of Congress Party is also totally based on falsehoods and not on genuinity of the substance. And can this gentleman be quiet for a while? Please behave, sir. This is not the way we debate, sir, Mr. Abbas. I hope you are an educated gentleman, sir. This is not the way we debate. This is not the way we debate, sir. Can I please complete, Mr. Abbas, and then you can shout, then you can threaten us, Mr. Abbas, kindly.
I hope lekin, Patra, 1 minute, Abbas Hafeez, I'm asking him to respond. On the question that you've raised, and the question is the timing. Well, the Delhi High Court does not find any problem with the timing, because even in the second wave, construction activity is allowed. But because this is the Central Vista and this was called the Vanity Project, Dr. Patra, would you want to respond on the timing issue?
I will do that, and sincerely request that please don't allow the absurdity of Mr. Abbas to come into the middle of our discussions. Let's have a cool debate. Thank you. Navika, let's assume that the Modi government would not have gone ahead with this Central Vista project, and suddenly Mr. Modi would have cancelled and called off the Central Vista project. You know what would have happened the next day? The very next day, Mr. Rahul Gandhi would have held a conference with some unknown economist in US, a virtual conference in which Rahul Gandhi would have been taught by the so-called economist. Modi ji cancelled the Central Vista. That is why 42% of economy has been hit. Construction work has been hit, and thousands and lakhs of people have been kept aside from their employment. And then Mr. Rahul Gandhi would have tweeted the next day, Modi ji, start the project. Don't call off the project. This is policy paralysis. Right, you know what the Congress Party and Rahul Gandhi does? They burn the candle both ways.
That's the point. And let me get in Ghanshyam Tiwari. That is the point. The point is, chit bhi meri, pat bhi meri, opposition for the sake of opposition. You have to target Prime Minister Modi on any issue, koi bhi issue ho. Ab COVID hai, to us pe target kar lo. Central Vista hai, to us pe target kar lo. Kisi bhi cheez ka bahana banaiye aur target kariye. Chahe kuch bhi ho jaye. And that is the question I'm asking you. If it was a logical opposition, then you should have also contested and opposed the ITPO project also happening in Delhi, also costing many crores. And those crores could also have gone into the healthcare infrastructure. But you didn't do that. You didn't do that because in your own mind, it is the Central Vista which you have associated with Prime Minister Modi. You have labeled it vanity project. You have labeled it all sorts of things. I want to ask you, let's just be today, take a step back, look at the judgments of two courts. The Supreme Court, which has upheld the legality, and the Delhi High Court, which has said that the timing is not suspect because construction activity is going on. Logically speaking, can you still oppose this project, Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari? And therefore, should you not apologize to the Prime Minister for calling him names?
Well, I'll say three things. One is that you often ask, why do we question the Prime Minister? Well, we can't question his guru, Donald Trump. He's out of power in the US itself. So let's set that aside. As far as the vanity of things is concerned, we are in a state where CMI says that 97%, not one or two, which is typical list of punjipatis that back Bharatiya Janata Party, 97% of Indians are poorer. Our unemployment rate in the country overall is over nearly 15%. Rural unemployment rate after a long time is nearly 10%. Our economic performance is worse in 40 years. We have a team of people who are just a back of incompetent leaders who are riding on the popularity of the Prime Minister, but are not good finance ministers, not good education ministers, not good ministers for the department that they lead. They have no answers, no good health minister. They have no answers. We have a situation where state after state is putting open tender globally and getting rebuttal, saying that we can't supply you vaccine. This is a situation where the Prime Minister wants to do vanity in the name of Central Vista. Let him do it. If we have to apologize as an opposition, the point where the citizen must ask our apology is why the Indian Parliament met for less number of days as there are Sundays in the last 7 years. They are celebrating their 7 years in power. There have been more Sundays in the 7 years than the sitting in Parliament. The Parliament Committee does not meet. A government and a party that systematically weakens, fractures institutions of India. You take any ranking from press freedom index to institutional index, to democracy index. They have weakened India in India and abroad. And at that time, they want to splurge. They can splurge. They can splurge. They can buy two more aeroplanes for the Prime Minister because he wants to do more aerial surveys. They can buy, build more central vistas in BJP-ruled states. But the reality is the various states are requesting this government to fulfill their GST commitments they are not able to fulfill. This government is saying that they have to borrow more than 1.5 lakh crore to just fulfill their GST commitments. So this is a government, on one end, realizes that India faces a very... One of your viewers who's watching this interview is facing the worst crisis emerging from this pandemic. And on the other hand, we have a Prime Minister who's disconnected from the people, does not do a press conference, cannot address. I think possibly in 7 years, the Prime Minister looks the most incompetent he has ever looked. And he can definitely revise his image by doing a press conference here
well,
and there.
Well, Ghanshyam Tiwari, allow me to come in. You have said that we are facing our worst economic crisis. Maybe, absolutely right. But this is the first pandemic that we've seen of this nature, which has come after 100 years. It's not a regular time period in any country's history over the last 100 years. That's point number one, which you should keep in your mind. Point number two, you made an admission that ministers are not possibly the best. Ministers are not somebody who can actually reflect, any kind of efficiency. Incompetent. But they are riding on the Prime Minister's popularity. You're saying incompetent, but you're also admitting that they are riding the wave of the Prime Minister's popularity. So, ye to aap admit karenge na ki Prime Minister aapki badolat nahi baithe hain as Prime Minister. Apni popularity aur logon ki vote ki badolat baithe hain. Roj subah jab aap unko उठकर गाली देते हैं आपका सवाल पूछना हक है लेकिन जब सवालों के जवाब कोर्ट्स देती हैं तो वो एक्सेप्ट कर लेना भी आपका फर्ज बनता है isn't that right शहजाद पूनावाला he admits the popularity yet he will continue to criticize भाई किस लिए कोर्ट्स हैव गिवन द वर्डिक्ट शहजाद पूनावाला
And I deserve not to be called Nalika also on this debate after waiting for 20 minutes. So I hope no opposition person here will deny me.
Well, I don't use that language. I don't use that language and I don't allow that language to be used on my shows.
Obviously, I did not mean it for you. You are the senior most anchor in this country. I meant it for the people who have understood the message. Anyways, there are people who are less courteous than you, unfortunately, in this country. Now, let me make my point. Navika, this was a new parliament. It is not the Prime Minister's house that is being constructed, and it is also the Central Avenue project that is being done. Now, this project was never 20,000 crores. It was a new parliament, and the total cost of this project is 1,300 crores, which is being spent. Now, I want to ask if Sambit Patra's tweet has been marked as manipulated media by Twitter. Here is Priyanka Vadra, who said 20,000 crores is being spent on PM residence. Both of these facts have been contradicted by the High Court order, which is in front of me, 23 pages, which has given the scope of this work is only the construction of a new parliament building, by the way, endorsed by the UPA government, by the way, endorsed by Meera Kumar, whose letter you had shown exclusively on Times Now, by the way, shown also endorsed by Jairam Ramesh, who in 2012 said, we desperately needed a new parliament. Now, how was something that was desperately needed in 2012 not become a desperation now? Point number two, I want to ask this question of Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari. Look at his contradictory argument. He's saying that there's rising unemployment. So the solution to this is that the 400 or 500 people who are working on this project should not be given employment, even while other projects are going on. Even though this 1,300 crore project is actually essential, not declared by Mr. Narendra Modi's government, but declared by the courts of this country. This is a contradictory argument. This is the same party which once upon a time advocated for GST, but now after coming out of power, they are saying no GST. They are the same party who said we want Rafals, but after coming out of power, they say we don't want Rafals. Supreme Court also had to step in and give them a warning on Rafals because of the lies they were spreading. This is the same party that took a particular stand on farm laws. Now they have gone against the farm laws. This is the same party which said that we need parliament building very desperately in 2012. Today they say we don't want parliament building. This is the party that puts Rajniti, above Rashtraniti, they put Parivar Hit above Desh Hit, and the only reason this is being opposed is because commission ka mauka nahi mil raha hai, credit ka mauka nahi mil raha hai. If Rahul Gandhi is thinking that this is a non-essential kaam, then why doesn't he stop the Manora Hostel, which is costing 900 crores? So imagine, 1300 crores for the parliament building, where parliament...
No, no, no. Abbas Hafeez, the Congress says... The Congress says that the MLA hostel in Maharashtra is not being made by diverting any outlays. Now, even the 1100 crores that are being used for the Central Vista, that is also not diversion. There is a separate 35,000 crore.
Navika ji, earlier the Bharatiya Janata Party people were defending their own megalomaniac action. Comparing it to assembly building. Thank you, my dear teacher. Thank you. You know it better because you people are from that.
No, it's not about knowing better. Let's not mislead people on at least words and vocabulary.
They were defending it with the Chhattisgarh new assembly building. Now the Congress government in Chhattisgarh has stopped all the new construction. They have cancelled all the issued tenders of the new assembly building. This was Congress doing this. This was Congress done in the Chhattisgarh. Then now they have come up with Maharashtra Hostel. So they come up again and again with new things. Right now, just be your priority should be vaccinating everyone, giving employment to everybody, taking them out, bringing them out of the financial mess which you are...
So Abbas Hafeez, two questions to you. Number one, are the workers who are working on the Central Vista going to go and vaccinate the people? Are they the people who are going to vaccinate? So how is the vaccination drive getting stopped by the Central Vista construction? Question number one. Question number two, what about this is megalomania? Abbas Hafeez, explain to me, what is megalomania in this? Because is the Prime Minister going to sit alone in the Parliament? Is the Prime Minister going to sit alone in the Prime Minister's new Awas whenever it is made? Because if he ceases to be Prime Minister, the next Prime Minister will come and live. What is megalomaniac about this? Where is the megalomania? Explain to me.
He wants to replace their name. He wants a stadium on his name. He wants a stone over there.
Replace their names. So after all, it is who inaugurates this.
Achha, to wo hag sirf Nehru aur Gandhi parivar ka. Sambit Patra ji. Abbas Hafeez, asal baat ab nikli hai. Asli baat ab nikli hai. Wo chahte hain ke Nehru aur Gandhi ke naam pe jo smarak hai, bas wahi band ho jana chahiye. Uske baad kisi ke naam par nahi banna chahiye. Patra ji, 1 minute. I heard you, Abbas Hafeez. I'll have to lower your fader. Dr. Patra, respond.
Given up by the Congress Party. The objection of the Congress Party is who would inaugurate the projects, and their names, in fact, would be written on the project. So that is the issue. They wanted that the names of the Gandhi should be engraved. The names of a single family should be engraved in every structure. That's their pain. That's their heartburn. And it is totally flown out today from the window while Mr. Abbas, in fact, speaks out the truth. Navika, we have to stick to the facts and we have to do away with the canard. What the facts are? Fact number one, it's not 20,000 crore rupees at one go. Several years, in fact, as far as 20,000 crore rupees is concerned. Initially, only two projects, not even the Prime Minister's home, have been sanctioned. Project number one, Navika, can you please put down the fader of Mr. Abbas? Can I please complete, Navika? Can we have a courteous debate? Navika, I request you, because this is not the way. Thank you, Navika. Navika, my sincere submission are the facts. You give me, please, 30 seconds to put forth the fact. Fact number one, it's not 20,000 crore rupees which is going to be spent at one go. Over the years, it will be spent. Right now, how much is being spent? 800 crore rupees for one project, that is the new building, and 400 crore rupees for the second project, that is the Central Vista Avenue. Not even the Prime Minister's residence, not even the Prime Minister's Awas has been talked about. Point number
so, Ghanshyam Tiwari, is the opposition's problem with the plaque which will be inaugurated by the Prime Minister? Does it boil down to that? Hum itni choti soch rakhte hain ke Nehru Gandhi ke parivar ke naam se sari buildings ho sakti hain, lekin kisi plaque par Modi ka naam nahi aana chahiye. Is that the basic issue? That is why it's being called a megalomaniac and a vanity project?
Well, the basic issue is that we have a very incompetent government led by a prime minister who cannot face the press in the face of very tough pandemic that is destroying economy and that is destroying life. And in the face of it, this government is building structures. They can build whatever structures, buying planes, but they are not helping people. And such a government is not only backed by an incompetent prime minister, there's an incompetent cabinet in place. So you don't see a leadership that is necessary. And when they start focusing on such mergers, the nation must ask, people must ask that who is responsible.
Shehzad Poonawalla, incompetent prime minister, incompetent cabinet, and yet they win elections. First time in three decades in 2014 with a complete majority of one party and better their performance of 2014 in 2019. Does this wash as an argument?
So I'll ask you, incompetence, does it mean that you have 10% of the population, that is Maharashtra, but you contribute 28 to 29% of the cases and deaths right from the beginning of COVID? Does incompetence mean that the five states where you are in power, Punjab, Rajasthan, Jharkhand, Maharashtra and Chhattisgarh, you have 22% of the population, but you contribute 50% of the cases? And also megalomania. By the way, megalomania means that when Nehru died, his house, his prime ministerial residence became Nehru Memorial Library. When Indira Gandhi died, her house became the private property and trust of the Gandhi family. And when this prime minister, when he will move on, this house which will be built, whenever it is built, will not be his personal trust property. It will go to the government of India, it will go to the people of India, and the next prime minister, wherever he will be from, will actually occupy that house. So you know what is megalomania, Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari? Please go and ask Rahul Gandhi, he'll give you the definition of megalomania. Only one family should have everything in its name. That is megalomania.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is the Supreme Court which first declared that the legality of this project was absolutely fine and the government had the right to go ahead. And today, the timing question has been addressed by the Delhi High Court and they have given their go-ahead as well as imposed a penalty on this frivolous, quote-unquote, motivated PIL that was put in. But the big message here is, why does the opposition in India need to direct its ire against one man, that is Modi? And if they would do it with facts, possibly there would be an informed debate in this country. But to call it Modi Mahal when Modi Bungalow or the Prime Minister's Bungalow is not even part of the first phase of construction, which they have been opposing, number one. And number two, there is only 1,100 crore sanctioned for one new parliament building and some avenues that are being made in the Central Vista. Why is there so much fake news and fake narrative around it? Would there be better place to apologize to the Prime Minister and put up an even better opposition when these issues that they are criticizing actually come up for construction? Should the debate happen then, not now? That's the big question. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for joining me on debate number one. Taking a short break, the economy debate coming up on the other side.